Hey, I'm Cher, and welcome to Readings. If you like the way I read, please like, share, and subscribe. Okay, Pisces. Pisces, I've already done a Pisces reading, but you know, that was meant segregated for one or two subscribers. Let's see if we can pick up on something different. I put the Gypsy Witch fortune-telling cards away. They are deep. And they bring out the skeletons out of the closet. Yes, indeed, you do. So let's go to the Tattoo Tarot and find out what Pisces is up to. Let's see if we can pick up on many, many energies instead of pointing out one or two energies. Come on, Pisces. 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 Singular. I'm swimming alone. Let's get her on, and let's get her done. How you doing, darlings? I can hear the chattering. Yes, I'm back again. Pisces, got the Eight of Cups. Damn, someone walked away. I'll be damned if they didn't. Look at that. Somebody walked away, or you walked away. Now, normally, the Eight of Cups is not standing straight up all neat like that, no. Eight of Cups is usually all kicked over. It's usually a bad ending, a bad leaving. Not so much an ending, just a bad leaving. And it was such a bad leaving that it left Pisces extremely, extremely heartbroken with the Three of Swords. Very, very much with a broken heart. Oh my God almighty. All right, Pisces. Here we are with the Tower. Broken heart, Tower. Lot of heavy feelings. Just depends on what part of the tower that you're in. If you're just going into the tower with this broken heart, it could be is that you're just laying there numb. The world is just going around you and you have no recognition of it whatsoever. You just look and it's day, and you look and it's night. Day, night, day, night, day, night. That's the beginning of the tower, and that's usually the middle of the tower also, where the most pain just comes right in. You're getting it from all four walls when you're stuck in the middle. So with the heartbreak that I got here with the tower, I'm going to say, Pisces, if you haven't just entered, then you're right in the middle of that cyclone. With the Two of Pentacles, feeling a lot, very unsteady. Feeling imbalanced. Feeling, well, yeah. Damn. What the hell happened when they left or when you left? Because for it to bring in imbalance, tower, pain, suffering. This is definitely somebody who is numb. Absolutely numb. Feeling unstable, feeling hard to get grounded, hard to get your feet on the ground. Just laying there. My God, you could be dealing with a Gemini too, or you could be dealing with an Aries. Could be dealing with Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. What I got here with the Five of Cups, there's a possibility that you're grieving an air sign. Possibility here that, air sign might have had a few words for you before they left, or you might have had a few words for them. My God, this is deep and this is dark. This is very, very sad, very emotional. A lot of pain. With the Five of Cups, this is grief. Now, I gotta tell you, Pisces, is that when you're in a state like this, you don't really see two full cups right behind you. You just see what was, not what can be. You don't see the hope that's right behind you. All you can see is the pain, the agony of what has happened. Day, night, day, night. Bam, we got the Lover's card, which is a Gemini. Definitely a Gemini here. Gemini, Aries, water sign. The Lover's card, this is true love. Okay, so This is what we don't understand about the Lovers. You see, the Lovers used to be three people. In the old tarot, it was three people in the tarot deck. But it caused controversy, and it caused a whole big thing that blew up into a big pile of bullshit, because they were thinking that there was somebody else, and it was three people with each other, and it just really went way out of control. But with the three people, what it meant was there was probably two, but making the decision for the one. And here's, okay, so it's made the decision on who they love, true love. So Pisces, what you're not seeing is the two full cups right behind you. You're just laying there feeling absolutely like it's the end of the damn world. But it's not. When I got the Judgment card, that's the Angel of Judgment blowing its mighty trumpet, bringing the dead back around again. This is not over. There's no way that this is over. With the two cups sitting behind you, and you don't even see them. Don't even see them, but with the Lovers card and the Judgment card coming out together, there is definitely a coming back. Person loves you, Pisces. There it is. With Three of Cups, there's a celebration. As I said, two people very much in love. Calling in the third. What is the third? Friends, family, co-workers, the neighbors. Whoever wants to come, come on in. Help us celebrate. Usually that's three lovely ladies on this card. All up in the air. Dancing, feeling light, feeling glee. Oh my god, Pisces, get up off the freaking couch, man. Holy crap, with the Ace of Cups coming in. And I just love it because, you know what, it's just... Alright, so if you take a look, three drops on the top, three drops on the top. On the other side, that's a six. With the four drops on the bottom and the four drops on the other side, that's an eight. Eight is a sign of completion. Six is, to me, the equal give and take, the joy, the love. And the two love doves on the bottom there. Pisces, get up. Get up and reassess the situation. All right, so what happened was, Pisces, I think that you might have gotten yourself all up in you because, hey, I'm a Pisces. I freaking know how I can get myself all up in me sometimes. Not as much anymore because I'm old, but, you know. But you youngins out there, you know, in your 40s and 50s and your 30s and your 20s, you youngins, you know, you get thinking that maybe somebody might be playing the field or something like that. You get yourself all up in defense and all believing things and... You know, sometimes we are our worst freaking enemies. With the Eight of Swords, that's exactly what happened. You might have thought that maybe it was too good to be true. It's too damn good to be true, so therefore it can't be true. And then Pisces, well, if it's not true, then they get up in their head with the Eight of Swords, getting all trapped up in the head. Tick, 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 tick. Well, you know, I can't be the only one. This is too good to be true. And I really don't. I wonder if they really do love me like they say they love me. Or I wonder. And by the way, I wonder. Over and over and over. Tick, tick, tick. Too much emotion. Too much in the head. Too much believing stuff that... Actually, you have no data on. You have no basis on. And please do not listen to a third party, Nosy Nosenstein, who just got to get their freaking nose stuck in there because they're jealous. Do not listen to a Nosy Nosenstein. Never, ever, ever. If you don't have the facts, don't listen to the bullshit of the Nosy Nosenstein. Here comes the leap. There's the fool. There it is. This is thinking about them over and over and over and over in all different ways, calling out their name, their name just friggin' echoing in your head. And the same with them. The leap is coming because your name echoes in their head. Pisces, 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 Pisces. Pisces, 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 Pisces. Echoing. Could be dealing with a Gemini here. There's some kind of devilment here, and spirit's telling me that this is not addiction. You know what? We're just going to have to go with the channeling in. When spirit speaks, the cards mean crap. I listen to spirit each and every time, and each and every time, spirit is tickety-boo. Hits the nail on the head. This is listening to some bullshit. That's what this is all about here. Listening to the nosy Nosenstein. That's the devil that's in this deck. Ten of Pentacles. Spy card. Also wealth. This is a wealthy relationship. But someone's listening to somebody and they shouldn't be freaking listening to. The Four of Pentacles and the Eight of Pentacles. I'm sorry, the Four of Swords and the Eight of Pentacles. This is very, very good. It truly is. And you really got to pay attention, Pisces. You really got to heal from this tower and this thing that you got yourself into. Because I really do feel that maybe some emotion got involved here and you might have thought that somebody was doing something behind your back or it was just too good to be true and you might have listened to a nosy Nosenstein. And you know what? I truly feel, Pisces, that, Jesus, there's a Four of Wands. I truly feel, Pisces, that this is not the first relationship that you've had where you've had some problems. There could be some kind of, through thought and believing bullshit, that you could have tried to control the situation through belief of maybe somebody's doing something or trying to control the relationship through a nosy Nosenstein. I'm going to have to rein them in and really get them in here and buckle them down. No. You got to let people be free. You got to trust. And kind of what I got here is it might be a lack of trust. But I really have, you've got to get the strength to stop fighting the inevitable. Because I really feel that your emotions get very much involved here. That you, I don't know, Pisces, if you're maybe trying to change them. Come on, you accepted them the way they were. When you started dating or when you met, you accepted them for the way they were. I'll never understand why people try to change other people. It's like, this was me when you met me. Don't be trying to change me. And it's kind of what I got. You got to get the strength to fight yourself here. Because when I got the marriage card, I really do have good things here in this reading. You think it's over. You think it's over. Yep, okay. You got to tell yourself something here, Pisces. All right, so you think it's over. I got the Ten of Cups for the two of you. I got the house, the home, the love, the kids, the whatever it is that the two of you thoroughly enjoy. But you got to give each other space and give each other some freedom. And knock off with the... You probably don't even realize that you're controlling through emotion, but there is emotion based here, and especially if you're dealing with Gemini, a very emotional person, big thinker, gotta think things to death. They seem to be very slow, but when they do finally decide on something, damn, that's what they do. But I got here that there is emotion, but there's something that you're not seeing, Pisces, is you got to tell yourself the truth here. You got to tell yourself the truth. is that I got the devil involved here, and the Ten of Pentacles. So whatever this devil is, it can be beat. It's not an addiction. It is an emotion. It is an emotion. Let's pull a couple more cards and just see what we have here. But this is definitely not over. There's some kind of, yep, here it comes. Some kind of karmic here. But it can be a beat karmic. It's not a toxic karmic. It is for you to learn, Pisces. For you to learn that you just might come off a bit strong sometimes because of your emotions. And what I have here is a little bit of karma, but stay on course. Okay, what's that last card? Stay on course. There's a little bit of karma here. And that karma is the bullshit that you're going through right now in the tower and the broken heart. That's your karma, darling. You want to get your emotions all tangled up into a relationship, be prepared to get the taste of karma. So you got to learn, darling, to breathe it in and breathe it out. Stop listening to your damn emotions, because Pisces, my God, our emotions can deceive us so much. Don't get emotions and intuition confused. But stay on course, because I do have wanting to be recognized. Somebody wants to come back in and be recognized here. Pisces, God love you, darling. My God. Who can't love a Pisces? What? I'm telling you, we are a carnival, aren't we? We all rides. So, we definitely have an Aries. All signs are here, but what is prominent? Aries, Gemini, huge, huge Gemini. Let's keep going. What do we got? We got a Sagittarian. We have a Capricorn. Gemini is here again. Aries is here again. Aries is big. Gemini is big. We've got Pisces. Let's keep her going here. With the Justice card, of course, we have the Libra. We have Leo. Pisces, huge air here, huge air, and huge cups, water. Pisces, okay. Thanks for joining me again today. That's a different reading than the last one, but I was just feeling uncomfortable about that last Pisces reading because that was not meant for the population. I really do believe that this is going to resonate with a lot more of you than the last one. The last one was definitely a message to someone. Have a wonderful night, and we'll see you tomorrow. Namaste.